And tonight, the Oklahoma soldier accused of leaking those documents is being called a hero. I'm Paul Folger.
I'm Jessica Schambach. Private First Class Bradley Manning is in solitary confinement. Tonight, supporters all over the world and right here in Oklahoma held rallies saying Manning just exposed the truth. Eyewitness News 5's Mark Ockgren is live with our big story. Mark?
Yeah, that's right, Jessica. In fact, those supporters who marched here to the Capitol this evening say they wholeheartedly stand in solidarity with Manning. They say if he, in fact, did what he's accused of doing, they say he should not be prosecuted.
Save our democracy from the tyranny of war.
Nearly two dozen people marched on the Capitol in support of Oklahoma soldier Bradley Manning. Manning is suspected of leaking thousands of classified documents about the war in Afghanistan to the website WikiLeaks. He's being held in a military jail. The marchers say the documents released to the public is justified, and if Manning did it, he should be called a hero and not a traitor.
What he is being convicted of is not a crime. We need more people like this in this world.
But the military calls Manning a criminal. They say the documents' release put the lives of soldiers and Afghans at risk. The Pentagon has about 100 people reading the leaked documents to assess the damage and to alert Afghans who might be identified by name. The Taliban says they would use the material to try to hunt down people who've been cooperating with the Allied forces. A friend of Manning told us his childhood friend is very patriotic. And if he did leak the documents, he must have felt it was the right thing to do.
If he did it, he believed he was doing the right thing, and he wanted us to know what was going on.
And in fact, Jordan said he last talked to Manning about a year ago. That was right before he went to off overseas to his deployment. Now, he says both of them, especially Manning, always wanted to join the military ever since they were little kids. We're live at the Capitol. Mark Ockgren, Eyewitness News 5.